Hi, welcome to SBR Sports Picks. I'm Peter Loschak. Today is Friday, December 2nd. This is the Into the Weekend with BetDSI show for college football week 14. We're talking with Brent from BetDSI discussing the notable betting action that he's seen over the course of the week. Of course, week 14 in college football conference championship games. So a lot of high profile games this week. Brent, do these conference championship games take higher than normal betting action or about the same?
About the same. I mean, in terms of the daily volume that's going to get wagered on the day, it's going to be about the same. But the nice thing, at least sitting from our counter, instead of, you know, spreading this over, you know, 50 to 70 games, we're looking at like 10 or 15 games that we're spreading all that action over. So on a game-by-game basis, we're going to get a ton more action for sure. If we look at, you know, the entire day, what our handle is, it's probably going to be about the same. But, I mean, we've got so much going on right now. I mean, there's NHL going on. There's UFC stuff, the NBA basketball, college basketball. It's just insane, the volume right now. One thing I have noticed that we're getting slightly less action, kind of like the advanced action, simply because people have to manage their bankrolls a little better.
Yes.
So you're sitting here on Wednesday and you might love a Saturday line, but you're like, wow, you know, if I tie out my bankroll, what am I going to do Thursday, Friday in terms of playing these college games, hockey games, whatever it may be? So you got to have a little more, you know, a few more guns in your holster, you know, kind of to be able to fire on all this stuff, or you've got to really manage your bankroll.
Right. Okay. Well, the first game I want to ask about is Florida, Alabama. Alabama did go up a little bit from the early opening line. I saw about 22. Now it's up to 24, but it hasn't gone over 24. So I'm assuming the public all over Alabama and probably definitely no sharp action as yet on Florida. What can you tell us about the line, the betting volume on Florida, Alabama?
Yeah, I mean, we're pretty split on this game. It's, I mean, in terms of the actual wager count and stuff like that, I'm actually surprised that it's not that bad. But I mean, the number's so high, kind of, you know, lends itself to people who don't want to really lay that. It's such a high number, and people are maybe grabbing, you know, Florida back at the high prices. Like, we got, you know, a couple full limit bets at plus 24 and a half and plus 24. We're sitting all right there. But I mean, we've got, you know, decent action on Alabama as well. My count's, you know, is about, you know, 1.5 times in favor of Alabama. So I am getting more bets in terms of the actual number of wagers I'm taken. They are with Alabama, but mostly public stuff. Looking at my money's about 2-1 favoring Alabama, so nothing really crazy either way. I don't have any sharps involved on the side at all. I got what we're going to call a pseudo sharp who is involved on the total this one, and he's on the under 41, so that's worth noting, because as expected, of course, I've got more wagers, actual number of bets I've taken, almost 3-1 favoring the over. So, you know, a high line like 24, you figure, wow, you know, if Bama's going to cover the 24, they're probably going to go over the 40. So that's probably, you know, part of the thinking of this. But I definitely have a lot more wagers on the over, but I do have sharper action on the under, and the under came at 41. Not a list guy, but someone that I would consider pseudo sharp for sure.
Okay, and then I want to ask about Virginia Tech Clemson. This is maybe the most highly debated game of the week. Some people saying Clemson's going to absolutely roll. Others saying that Virginia Tech getting 10 is a gift. I'm assuming, though, that the public is all over Clemson, and based on the relatively little line movement that we've seen so far, probably no sharp action as far as the side's concerned.
Yeah, you're right. I don't have sharp action involved yet. Yesterday, we're sitting on this game. We had Clemson minus 10, minus 115. We're sitting at minus 10.5 right now, and that's just public money that's coming in so far on Clemson that playing Virginia Tech. My wager count's almost like 3-1 in terms of the actual number of bets I've taken favoring Clemson. My money favors Clemson as well. So, you know, no surprise there in terms of the money being, you know, driving line up from the 10 minus 15 to 10.5. But I don't have any sharps on either side, as you kind of expected, Peter. You know, talk about totals. I don't even have to tell you what the total situation is like, but it's all over on the over, of course. Wager count of almost like 6-1 favoring the over. So that's quite a heavy count in terms of the actual number of bets I've taken going on the over. Just public money so far, though. I mean, we came out at 57, we're up to 58.5. So, you know, you see gradually the line has been creeping up. We did actually, you know, we went half point at a time because it's public money. So we went from 57.5 all the way up to where we are at 58.5. Got a little dribbles back, you know, on under 58.5, but nothing. You know, actually, if I look at my chart and the actual money taken so far at 58.5, it's probably balanced. So we might stick there, but so far it's all public money that's driven the over and public money on Clemson as well.
All right. And then Oklahoma State, Oklahoma. I gave Oklahoma State as an official play in our shows here at SBR early in the week. It opened at 13.5. Now it's down to 11 or 11.5. Maybe that was indicative of some early sharp action on Oklahoma State at 13 or so. And is the public favoring either one? Probably Oklahoma. Maybe this is a game where you have a notable sharp public split.
I wish I did. I don't have really, you know, any sharps involved at all in this one.
Oh, okay.
We are sitting Oklahoma minus 11.5. My wager count slightly favors Oklahoma State just a little bit. So nothing, you know, nothing big here in terms of the wager count. No real big decision. Looking at my money, it's almost the same too. It's my money definitely slightly favors Oklahoma State. My money slightly favors Oklahoma. My wager count slightly favors Oklahoma State, but nothing big there. I do have action on the total as well. This is another game where, you know, a good spot for us where you're always looking for sharp action going against public action. And this game is a sharp play where I do have sharp money on the under 78. So we're sitting at 76.5 right now. My wager count, though, is almost like 3-1 favoring the over. So that's maybe no surprise, but definite sharp action on this one, which is under 78, Peter.
All right, so the first clear sharp action of the week we've identified under in Oklahoma State. Oklahoma, what else can you tell us about notable action from College Football Week 14?
I can tell you, looking at this game, you know, Baylor-West Virginia before the season started, we probably wouldn't have expected a line being what it is. West Virginia, a monster favorite here at home. Yesterday, we were sitting at 17. We had actually opened up at, like, taken sharp action, at 16. So sharp action came on West Virginia at 16. Yesterday, we were 17. Today, we're 17.5 because the public's kind of tailing the sharp action that did come in. But I do have sharp action on this one. West Virginia minus 16 is where that came in. So sharp action, definitely to note on this one. West Virginia now is a 17.5 point favorite at home to Baylor. Sharps, like I said, we're in on this one at the minus 16. We touched about the Oklahoma total there. Oh, here's a one. South Alabama, probably the strongest play on the board so far in terms of the two guys who are on it who are very, very sharp. We took our first sharp bet on South Alabama. They're a home favorite playing New Mexico State. The first hit came at 10.5. I have another sharp who came in at 12.5. We're sitting at 13.5 right now in South Alabama, so that number's just crept up on sharp action. I do have, you know, kind of public action kind of going with them as well. We're sitting at 13.5 right now. My wager count's almost, you know, it's about 2.5 times in favor of South Alabama, so, you know, I'm getting a little bit of money back on New Mexico State, but nothing sharp at all. No big bets on New Mexico State, but two big sharps came in on South Alabama, minus 10.5 and minus 12 as well, so that's definitely worth noting there. Western Kentucky, they're playing Louisiana Tech. West Kentucky is now a 10-point favorite. Took sharp action on Western Kentucky, minus 7.5, so quite a move there. My wager count in terms of the actual number of bets I've taken, almost 2-1 favoring Western Kentucky. Money is about 5-1 favoring Western Kentucky because of the sharp action that came in. Again, Western Kentucky, minus 7.5 is where that came. I have two sharps involved on the total in this one as well, so take note of that. It's always nicer when you got a couple of guys going the same way. Under 81.5 and under 81 on this game. We're sitting at 80 right now, and again, my wager count is, you know, you say, why are we sitting at 80 right now? And, you know, why haven't we moved more? You know, only a full point down from the last bet. Again, 81.5 and 80 is where they came. But the public money is just so overwhelming, favoring the over, which is kind of no surprise. You expect, you know, a team to blow another team out, where it looks like this is a situation like that. So wager count is almost like 8-1 favoring the over, which is quite a big count there. Another total here is Temple and Navy. I've got sharp action on the under of this one. I also have two different guys involved on this one. They came under 64, and the second bet came under 62.5. We're sitting at 60.5 right now. Again, I've got almost three times as many actual bets on the over, so I got public money on the over, sharp guys on the under there, and that about covers it for sharp action.
Wow, not a lot of individual plays, but some very, very interesting stuff. Unders, sharp guys coming in under in Western Kentucky and Louisiana Tech, but also on the favorite, Western Kentucky. Very, very interesting, Brent. Thanks so much. We'll talk again very soon for hopefully some bowl action.
Go to SBRodds.com. Browse, compare, and shop live odds available at top online sportsbooks.